What's up, Mets fans? Welcome back. Talking Mets to Rob. How's everybody doing? Before I get started about Trevor Rosenthal to the Mets, don't forget, guys, if you enjoyed this video, smash on that like button. And if you're enjoying my videos, all my content, want to get notified when I post my videos and go live, hit on that subscribe button, everybody. All right, guys, so Trevor Rosenthal to the Mets. Since we heard the news this morning about Seth Lugo and the bone spur issue that he had, the foreign body that came loose, and now he has to have surgery to remove that foreign body, he's going to be out at least 6 weeks and going to get reevaluated in 6 weeks in a throwing program that could expand to another 6 weeks. So he's projected to come back sometime in May. So that is a big blow to the Mets. He is the best reliever in the Mets bullpen, and it's a huge blow. And the bigger issue is now, who's going to fill his role? Now, you can say Trevor May can be that guy. He's very solid when he pitched for the Twins, but at this moment in time, he's not Seth Lugo. Lugo was very versatile, pitched anytime he needed him. Obviously, he started last year in 2020, came in the seventh, came in the eighth, closed games. He did everything. So it's going to be very hard to fill Seth Lugo's role, but the Mets have to do it somehow. We were looking for a left-handed pitcher, such as Justin Wilson, as we all know about him the last 2 years with the Mets. But now we have to look at somebody that can fill a spot in that bullpen for at least 2 months for the season and beyond, because we don't know how good Lugo is going to be when he comes back. It might take him longer. We don't know. And then the rumors and the speculation about Trevor Rosenthal coming to the Mets. Could the Mets be interested? Well, they probably will be now. Now that we're looking for probably two relievers and not just one. So when it comes to Trevor Rosenthal, is it a good idea to go after him in respect to the Mets making him a target and a part of this Mets bullpen? Well, I want to look at his stats, because the biggest thing that we've been talking about with any player during the offseason is the 2020 stats and the 2019 stats. A lot of us, not just Mets fans, baseball fans, said that a lot of 2020 stats you don't want to really look into, and I'm one of them. I'm going to take those with a grain of salt, because we've seen with Trevor Bauer, he pitched in one of the worst divisions in baseball and won the Cy Young when he faced the AL Central and NL Central when he pitched for the Reds. Now, when we look at the stats for Trevor Rosenthal, we're going to look at his full year of 2019 and the shortened year of 2020. So when we look at his stats right here, in 2019, he pitched for Toronto and Washington. If you look at his 2019 stats in Toronto, before he was traded to Washington, he had a 13.5 ERA. And then in the same year, when he got traded to Washington, he had a 22.74 ERA. And then, again, still in 2019, a 7 ERA for Detroit. In total, he pitched around close to, I would say, a little over 30 innings. Home runs weren't a factor. A lot of walks. I mean, with Toronto, he had 26 walks in 15 innings, 15 walks in 6 innings, 11 walks in 9 innings. It's over a walk per inning. And it's not good. I mean, it's just not. Strikeouts were okay, but he wasn't good in 2019. The last full season Trevor Rosenthal had, his ERA was outrageous. It was terrible. And that scares me, because even when we look at 2020, which we will do right now, with Toronto, he had a 1.9 ERA. Nice. Then he went to Kansas City, 3.29 ERA. Now, and then he had, with San Diego, 0 ERA. pretty good in 9 games, 4 saves, 10 innings. He got better in 2020. But if you want to take every player with a grain of salt when it comes to their stats in 2020, you have to look at Rosenthal also. We always look at Trevor Bauer and his stats before 2020. Career ERA of about 4. And you could look at a lot of other pitchers, bullpen and starters, that might have had better years in 2020 and never had another year like that in their career in the full season. With Trevor Rosenthal, his last full season was terrible. 13.5, 22.74, and 7 ERA with 3 different teams in 2019. Again, in 2020, he pitched a lot better. He was really damn good. But we have to take into consideration a full season. Now, you can say, you know, it could have been injuries. There was injuries, but he did pitch. You know, he didn't pitch a lot of games. He didn't. It was the injuries. Perfectly understandable. But at the end of the day, we have we heard it all on Twitter, social media. You hear a lot of them like, now we have to, we should really focus in on Trevor Rosenthal and Justin Wilson, which I think Justin Wilson for sure is going to be probably a part of this bullpen, in my opinion. I just believe that. It just makes sense for both sides. When the Mets first signed Justin Wilson, it was 2 years, $10 million. So I would expect that type of deal. Maybe 2 year deal, $9 million, 2 year deal, $10 million, might be the same thing. So it really looks like the Mets could be really focused in on Trevor Rosenthal also as that right-hander in the bullpen also to fill in for Lugo. He wouldn't probably pitch. He might pitch the same role as Lugo, you know, in the 6th, 7th, 8th inning type of role. Is he going to be as good as Lugo? Probably not. If he pitches the way he did in 2020, I take that. But there's no guarantee because his last full season was a disaster. So when you look at the projected stats for 2021 for Trevor Rosenthal, it looks like this. A 4.81 ERA, 30 walks, 7 home runs, 66 strikeouts. Now, that's not good. Nearly a 5 ERA. If that's something you're going to look at and say, that's the guy you want in the bullpen to fill in for Lugo until Lugo comes back, you're already putting more fuel on that fire, especially with Familia and Betances if they're still in his bullpen. And at this moment, they still are in his bullpen, so we have to talk about those two. Familia was okay. Betances was a disaster. He had the injury, but when he really pitched, he wasn't really that good either. So you could be potentially having 3 arms in Familia, Betances, and Trevor Rosenthal all potentially not pitch well out of the bullpen. They could all pitch well. You know, obviously it's up in the air. We don't know. But if you're going to look at the Baseball Reference's projected stats, it is not good. And that's what we're looking at. And when it comes to a contract that Trevor Rosenthal looked at, his last contract was 2 years, $14 million. So he's getting $7 million a year. I have a feeling that it could be a 1 year deal for Trevor Rosenthal. But if you're his agent, if you're Trevor Rosenthal's agent, you're going to show teams his 2020 stats because they were really damn good. So you might ask for a 2 year deal, maybe another 2 year, $13, $14 million deal. So it would be about $6 or $7 million a year. Will the Mets do that? I don't know. It seems like they want to get these relievers for a 1 year deal. You know, that seems like what the Mets are trying to do, because I think a 2 year deal would probably get it done for either Justin Wilson and Trevor Rosenthal. But with Trevor Rosenthal, a 2 year deal probably is what him and his agent are looking for, especially the year he had in 2020. And if Trevor Bauer can get all the money he wants for a year he had in 2020 in a shortened season, pitched against the worst 2 divisions in baseball in AL Central and NL Central, then why can't Trevor Rosenthal ask for a two-year deal worth $14 million? That's just the only thing that I can think of. You know, it's possible that the Mets say, listen, we'll give you a one-year deal, a show-me type of deal. That could do that, but it probably won't get Trevor Rosenthal. And at this moment, the Mets might be a little desperate in getting Trevor Rosenthal because of the Seth Lugo news that we got today. So it's possible the Mets can overpay, so to speak, to get Trevor Rosenthal for a two-year, $13 to $14 million overall worth in that deal. So that is my take on Trevor Rosenthal to the Mets. I want to thank you guys for watching. Don't forget, guys, smash on that like button if you enjoyed this video. If you enjoy my content, guys, my videos, want to see more, want to get notified when I post my videos and go live, guys, hit on that subscribe button, everybody. I want to thank you again for watching. And as always, let's go Mets.